Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. The search continued off Hampton Beach for a 12-year-old girl who went missing while swimming just before 8 Monday night. Officials say Naylene Encarnacion from Lawrence, Massachusetts, got into trouble. Her brother tried to save her but had to be rescued himself. We are told this afternoon Coast Guard officials are meeting with her mother. Ray Brewer has an update on the search.
As daylight came, the search continued for missing 12-year-old Naylene Encarnacion of Lawrence, Massachusetts. Even a Coast Guard jet assisted in looking for the little girl. According to police, Encarnacion was swimming about 75 yards offshore shortly before 8 o'clock Monday evening.
She began to have difficulty in the water. Her brother attempted to assist her and subsequently began to have difficulties himself. He was assisted out of the water by bystanders.
Police say a local man, Richard White, was primarily responsible for assisting the brother, 20-year-old Walter Maldonado, also from Lawrence. As the morning progressed, more people showed up. The search effort, a grim reminder of how dangerous the ocean can be.
Kind of devastating because I watch my two girls every day. And when we come up here every year, I tell them the same thing, stay away from the riptide because you never know when it's going to take you out.
But officials say while people may be speculating that riptides were responsible, it's not clear if that was the case.
That area is typically not one of our areas where we encounter rips.
Helping the Coast Guard in the search are members of New Hampshire Marine Patrol and Fish and Game. The Coast Guard says based on the currents, they may concentrate their search a little north of Hampton Beach, and they've decided to suspend the search from the air.
At this point, we have enough assets on the water, and we have good visibility, and we have daylight, so the best asset to use is surface assets.
As for the little girl's family, the police chief says they have been in touch with the mother, Jasmine Candida.
We've been in contact with the mother down in Lawrence. Coast Guard as well has been in touch with her. As you imagine, extremely distressed.
And stay with WMUR News 9 and WMUR.com for the latest on this still-developing story. We will bring you any updates as soon as they happen in the search for that missing 12-year-old. Well, a man charged in a Nashua homicide is being held without bail this afternoon. 20-year-old Ricky Munster is charged with second-degree murder. He made his first court appearance this morning. The body was discovered early yesterday morning on the side of Auburn Street. Investigators have not released the victim's name or saying how that person died, but an autopsy is scheduled for today. Well, the woman who was raped 14 years ago by a fellow church member is speaking out for the first time since that trial ended. On Friday, Ernie Willis was found guilty of sexually assaulting and impregnating Tina Anderson when she was 15 years old. Tina, who is now 29, is back home with her family in Arizona. The mother of three says the trial here in New Hampshire was torture at times, but she finally got her justice.
I was blamed. I was put in front of the church, made to apologize for allowing a compromising situation. And then I was shipped away and I had to give the baby up for adoption. I was thankful that I was finally believed, and I saw it kind of as a victory for rape victims everywhere.
Ernie Willis is being held at the Merrimack County Jail awaiting sentencing. He could face 50 years in prison. Well, coming up tonight, the developments in the search for a 12-year-old girl off the coast of Hampton Beach. Naylene Encarnacion had been swimming last night when she ran into trouble. Her brother went in after her, but then he had to be rescued. She has not yet been found. We are expecting another update from searchers this afternoon. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.